in computer, what kind of program we usually write in very simple program like position equal to initial plus rate into 60. So this is the instruction we usually write to calculate position for a given initial value. Now see, this was the steps what human brain usually uses or goes through at the time of reading some sentence and react to it. Now what compiler do? Compiler does lexical analyzer first. So what lexical analyzer? What is lexical analyzer? Lexical analyzer is just recognize characters or logical entities, or you can say the smallest part in a instruction or statement in the code. Okay, the same thing like the cat runs. So these three things in our human brain also we recognize them three individual things. So the same way lexical analyzer does. Next part is syntax analyzer. Here we check whether what words or small parts of the code you have read, they are written in proper format or not. So numbers of time when we do C coding, we usually get syntax error. So syntax error comes from this phrase. Okay, so this phrase, syntax error means you have not written your code in proper syntax or proper format. Okay, so this is the syntax analyzer. Next, if it is correct, grammatically correct, then we go for whether it is meaningful. Does it make some sense? If yes, the syntax analyzer checks that one. The semantic analyzer checks that one. Logical things, right? Next, if logically it is correct, then we go for intermediate code generation. Once we generate the intermediate code, we go for optimization of the intermediate code. Next, optimized intermediate code is used to generate the target code generation. Next, again we need to optimize the target code according to our machine. So these first three phases like lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer and semantic analyzer are called analysis phase, and these four phases are called as synthesis phase. Again, another is there lexical analyzer to optimization of intermediate code. These five phases are called as front end or machine independent, and the remaining these two phases are known as machine dependent. They are in fact machine dependent phase, or we also call them as back end. So what we had taken as a input like a position equal to initial plus rate into 60. So at that time of lexical analyzer, it recognizes each part as token. Okay, so what does it happen? Position is identifier, right? It is a variable name. So variable names are identifier. So it is like it generates token ID, it is the identifier, comma one. So it gives a you can say ID number to the position. So it is going to be treated as ID 1. This is the second identifier we have found in the code. So ID 2. This is third one. So ID 3. And ID 4 is the number, is a number that is 60. So this is also identifier. So constant is identifier. So if the syntax analyzer has a grammar like S to E, E to E plus T or T, T to T into F or F and F to ID. Next we can generate a syntax analyzer or syntax tree like this in the syntax analyzer, and it finds that okay, it can happen that ID 2 plus ID 3 multiplication ID 4. So it is possible. Okay, so syntax analyzer says that okay, it is possible to generate a syntax tree using the input statement or input instruction using the given grammar. So it goes for semantic analyzer. Semantic analyzer generates a syntax tree using what it finds out that whether they are logically correct or not, whether they can be mapped to each other. This operation can be done on between this left subtree and right subtree, and it checks all these things. If everything is okay, then it goes for intermediate code generation. So here you can see intermediate code generation. It takes a temporary variable temp1 equal to int to real. It converts 60 to real and stores temp1. Then temp2, another temporary variable equal to id3 into temp1, and temp3 equal to id2 plus temp2. So and finally id1 equal to temp3. So id1 gets the result. So once we have this, now we go for optimization of this code. So like here you can see we don't need temporary variable 2 at all. We can simply write temp1 equal to id3 into 60.0. So 60.0 is a real value, so we don't need to convert it again and store in a temporary one. The id1 equal to id2 plus temp1. So within two lines we can solve it. So this is optimization, right? Next one, I have the optimized code. We go for target code generation. So here we have generated the assembly code as a target code of the intermediate code.